السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. Dear sisters and brothers, are you feeling exhausted? Have you reached that point in the month of Ramadan where you feel tired? Well, subhanAllah, this is exactly where we need to be in this moment of the month. We talked about yesterday how Ramadan is a month of little food and little sleep. And it is a month where we need to actually feel the exhaustion in order to really make those behavioral changes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants for us. So if you're feeling exhausted because of the lack of sleep or lack of coffee, then that is exactly where we need to be in this moment right now. And if anybody is rumbling or grumbling about it, or perhaps it's their tummy that's rumbling and grumbling, that also is exactly where we need to be right now. Ramadan is a month where we need to push further. We take one more step or a few more. We pray a little bit more. We read a little more Quran and then some more. We do more dhikr. We give more charity and then give even more to where you can really feel that pinch. We talked about the difference between sympathy and empathy, and empathy is where you put yourself in the shoes of that person who doesn't have much, whether it be food or wealth. SubhanAllah, this is a month where we cannot say to ourselves, I don't have the energy to do more, because we remind ourselves that the battle of Badr was fought in Ramadan. And had it not been for that battle, we would not be here today. We remind ourselves that Fatah Mecca, or the opening of Mecca, also took place in the month of Ramadan some years later. We have to remind ourselves that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us that there are special things that happen in Ramadan that He's given to us and He's not given to anyone else, according to the hadith. For example, that in this month of Ramadan, the angels continuously ask for our forgiveness. SubhanAllah. And so we too must ask for forgiveness. That in this month of Ramadan, we're told in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the breath of the fasting person is sweeter to Allah than the scent of musk. Because Allah knows what He created. And He knows that we as humans will be self-conscious when we haven't brushed our teeth and haven't eaten or drank for a long time. Our breath starts to stink. But because we know that it's sweeter than the smell of musk, then this allows us to get through, subhanAllah. Also, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He saves thousands of believers from the hellfire in this month. And so we must ask continuously for atq min al-nar, to be able to be taken out of the hellfire. Also, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us Laylatul Qadr, the night of power, in which worship within it is better than and more than 1,000 months. That's roughly 80 some years. And even if you were to live to the ripe age of 80 some, it wouldn't be continuous worship for 80 years. It's impossible. So you have this one night of the month in which you can reap that much worship that you can't do in your entire lifetime. And not only that, but it repeats itself every year. SubhanAllah. Allah gives us these opportunities. Like we said before, Ramadan is like a bath, a purifier. It comes to wash us and comes to unclog those pores and to allow us to connect again with the divine and with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to push ourselves further, take one step more, one step further. Every time we feel like I've had enough, remind yourself that this is a month in which doing good is easy and doing bad is hard. And everything within it is multiplied at least 70 times, if not exponentially more, to the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how He believes each of us and our intentions of what we're doing. SubhanAllah. This is a month of the Quran, a month in which we need to read more Quran and connect to its deeper meanings and reflect and ponder on its meanings, whether that be in the reading of the translation or in understanding the tafsir, its exegesis, or in doing actual recitation with it within our prayers. We want to be sure to really spend that extra time with the Quran. And every time you spend, do a little bit more. This is a month where Allah has promised us more, but we must take the steps to do more. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from me and you, inshallah, today and every day. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate us and increase us and make us from those who are worthy of being forgiven this month, being showered with his mercy this month, and being taken out of the hellfire, if ever we were written to be part of it. Allahumma ameen. Barakallahu fikum. Please keep us in your du'as. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. This is your sister, Dr. Rania Awaad, signing off. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.